Want to learn how to add and configure widgets for your dashboard? Then stay tuned to find out. Hi guys, welcome back to part 2 of building your operations dashboard from scratch. Check out part 1 to see how far we got in this tutorial. I'll link it at the end of this video. So, now we need to add a few more widgets, but before we do, I just want to remind you what my dashboard will answer and to kind of recap what we've done so far. So, from my dashboard, I want to answer the following. Where are my field workforce collecting data right now, which has been added? How much roads have we maintained since January 1, 2015 in meters, also added? How many utility poles have we maintained before January 31, 2018 in relation to their status, also added? How many wooden utility poles need repairing? How is the utility pole material distributed in percentage? And how many commercial and residential buildings are there? Next, I want to add my widget to show me the total number of wooden poles to be repaired. I use a summary widget here, and I will use one of the filters that I created in my first tutorial. This is the widget that I use to pull out my wooden utility poles with the status being equal to in need of repair. If you need a reminder, you can go back to check on my first tutorial to see how these filters were created. I give it a name after selecting the filter to be repaired. For display type, I only need the total count for these, so I select that and change my color. I include a leading text, which means that this text will come before my feature count. I could add trailing text as well, which could come after the count, but I couldn't think of any. I reconfigured it to add a space after my leading text, so there is one between my text and my count. Now, I will add my widgets for my commercial and residential building count using the same summary widget I used previously. And I'm also using the filters that I created for my buildings layer when I filtered out the buildings with the type commercial and the second filter with the type residential. I want to add my widget to show the distribution of pole material in percentage, so I add a pie chart and select my utility pole feature. I use the entire feature layer here and select material as my value field, since I want to show this distribution particularly. And I also show labels in order to show the value in terms of percentage. I do one last thing to complete my dashboard. I add a legend using the legend widget. Now, my dashboard is complete and ready for action. I update the saving. Now, this is what my dashboard looks like. Now, I will collect some features in ArcGIS Collector to show you my dashboard in action. Just a warning, this is almost 1 minute of pretty much you just staring at the screen. So, if you want to leave this video now, then I totally understand. But if you stay, you'll be seeing the login widget being updated, as well as the poles to be repaired widget, and the number of commercial buildings increase. Thank you so much for tuning into this series. And what's next? I think we'll be doing an ArcGIS Pro series. I will be showing you how to edit, symbolize, create a layout, and share, as well as download from ArcGIS Online. But first, I'll be doing a review of ArcGIS Pro versus ArcMap. So make sure to subscribe and turn on your notifications so you can see when these tutorials are released. Again, thank you so much for tuning in. Please subscribe and share these tutorials with your colleagues and friends. Thanks again, and see you next time.